So first of all, what I want you to do is go to this section, the left section. Okay, you may not have this thing. Okay, you may not have a panel over here, but when I click on the second last icon or I press Control Y or Command Y on my keyboard, you'll get this. Okay, so what it basically is, it is basically a panel for the layers. Okay, here you will see various text layers and rectangles that you're going to make. All right, so first of all, what we're going to do is we'll make an artboard like this. This is black rectangle, you see. Okay, now how to make it? Click on the second last icon, which is called as the artboard tool. Okay, or press A on your keyboard. So this tool will be selected. Okay, now what I want you to do is you just have to click and drag it. Okay, so what it does is basically makes a random artboard. All right, over here you can see the width and the height of the artboard in pixels. The width is 457 pixels and the height is 870 pixels. But it is not a uniform size. I mean, in general, whenever you design, you take it with respect to some sort of phone or something. Okay, so I'm just going to delete it for now. All right, and I'll go back to this artboard tool. Okay, and over here on the right panel, you can see there are various options available. There's iPhone 10, iPhone 6, 7, 8, Google Pixel. Okay, there are even artboards available for tablets or desktop or social media and everything, even the watches. Okay, so select Google Pixel 4. Why am I selecting Google Pixel 4 is it gives you a good amount of width and height too. Okay, so this is the artboard. When I clicked on Google Pixel 4, this came over here automatically. Okay, now I would like to tell you something about operating Adobe XD. Now basically, to move around, if you are using laptop, what you have to do is with two fingers you just have to slide. Okay, whenever you slide towards left, you will move towards right, and when you slide towards right, you will be able to move towards left. Okay, so if you are using laptop, these are the things. And if you are using your mouse, so basically you have to click on the wheel and you will be able to drag the screen. Okay, to zoom in and zoom out, like you zoom in and zoom out on your phone, you just have to use two fingers and enlarge the thing in on your touchpad. Similarly to zoom out, and for the mouse, you have to press Control or Command on your keyboard, and simultaneously you just have to start using the wheel on your mouse. By doing this, you'll be able to zoom in or zoom out. Okay, now we have an artboard over here, but what I want to do is basically I'll be using the other artboards to make the design. So I'll be clicking on the name of the artboard and I will be dragging it over to the top. Okay, so I will be able to have the wireframe as well as our artboard as well. Okay, so the first thing is I want you to rename this. Now this is basically the name of this artboard is Google Pixel 4. Now to rename it, I will double click on it. Okay, and then using your keyboard you can name it anything. I'll be calling it wireframe. All right, next thing is to change the fill of this. You can see that there's a black color in this wireframe, whereas our wireframe is white. Why is it? Because by default the color provided is white. So to change the color of this to black, on the right panel you will get a section called as appearance. Okay, click on the fill. This like it will be like a translucent rectangle color white. Click on the fill and you will be able to choose any color you want. Suppose I click anywhere, now it becomes red. I click over here, it becomes gray. So I want you to take a color which is not exactly black, but really close to black. Suppose I'm taking this color value 070707. Okay, now if you don't know what is a hex value for the color, it's basically used to give color to objects in any software, any graphic design software. Okay, so this is the hex value 070707. you can copy it and put it in the fill color of your artboard.